Welcome back to the Demon Slayer Gaming Channel. We're going to be continuing our Let's Play series through Armored Core 6. Left off, we just unlocked some new arena stuff, Rank B. So let's go ahead and dive into those. We have V3 O'Keefe, third squad leader of the Vespers, the Aquibus Group's augmented human squad. O'Keefe is originally a member of an older generation of augmented humans, and during the island fourth disturbance, he worked as an agent carrying out espionage activities. He was later headhunted by Aquibus' information department and agreed to sign up on the condition that they provided him a Generation 9 augmentation surgery to counteract the coral burn-in on his brain. He has the legs that we have. I wouldn't say he's going to be super quick. So we'll go in with the cannons. See how it goes.
Arena Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program, number 12, entering Rank B. Subject AC, Baron Flower. Call sign, V3 O'Keefe. Commencing evaluation.
Probably be hovering a lot. System activating combat mode. Which hovering makes him pretty easy to shoot rockets. Going over my head every time that I'm shoot something at him. Okay. Hold off till the shield's gone. Almost done. One more hit should do it. If we can land a hit, thank you. Jesus, he's got some delayed rockets there.
AP at 30%.
Got him. Not bad. Yeah, those legs don't lead to much mobility, so all his dodging made him. Where it was easy to hit him at certain times. Cinder Carla, nice. The ringleader of RID and its chief engineer, responsible for the basic specifications of all of the organization's products. A specialist in data processing and machine design, and a fount of knowledge with an imaginative genius, Cinder Carla has produced a long line of eccentric and fanciful weapons, quite unlike those found in a corporate catalog. Her stated design philosophy, what use is a killing machine that can't get a good laugh? I like it. That's why hers is all multicolored. Like a clown.
Arena Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program, number 11. Rank. What is this?
Look at those guns.
I'm busy, but you can have this old data.
Main system activating combat mode.
Woo!
Okay.
So her hands shoot out missiles. Her shoulders shoot out missiles. She's like me. She loaded up. Hers are very delayed though, so a little bit easier to dodge.
Don't know about this.
It appears the data contained an unauthorized message. We apologize. Terminating evaluation.
All right, what we got next? Old Call, independent mercenary who bargained his way into the effortless entry to Rubicon, having anticipated the extraplanetary corporation's forays well before they made their move. A specialist in corporate wetwork, Cold Call removes undesirable elements on the behalf of those who do not wish to be seen getting their hands dirty. Quick to identify a fellow assassin, he claims that you can smell a real killer right through their AC. Okay. It looks like he may be a little quick, so we may have to swap weapons, but we'll see.
Arena Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program, number 10, rank B.
A sword?
AC, dead sled. Call sign, cold call. Commencing evaluation.
Main system, activating combat mode.
Okay. Man, not a sword, but that freaking gun that he has is ridiculous.
AP at 30%.
He is quick though. Is an issue for me and my rockets. Ooh, just barely. Hadn't activated our shield yet, but that was still pretty close.
Target destroyed. Concluding evaluation. Well done.
Rusty. Rusty's real quick, isn't he? Yeah, let me see. Let's swap the light machine guns. Fourth squad leader of the Vespers, the Equibus Group's augmented human squad, discovered through the recruitment program operated by Schneider, an Equibus affiliate. Rusty so quickly distinguished himself as he selected that he was selected to join the upper echelons of the Vespers in less than half a year. Rusty received augmentation surgery prior to joining the Vespers, and through the precise details, and though the precise details are unclear, he has declared himself to be of the 8th generation.
Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program, number 9, rank B. Subject AC, Steel Haze. Call sign, V4 Rusty. Commencing evaluation.
Main system, activating combat mode.
How's it doing, Rusty? Good. That kinda hurt. Ooh, that really freaking hurt. What? Sometimes I don't know why it does the things it does. HP shield.
Target destroyed. Concluding evaluation. Well done.
Honest Brute, leader of the Junker Coyotes, a major dozer force. Brute was originally hired by RAD. His smooth-talking, affable nature quickly caught the attention of Carla, who found him quite unlike the average dozer. When it was discovered that the man was a psychopath and a pathological liar, he fled, taking a considerable amount of RAD's funds and technology with him, a loss that was too great for Carla to tolerate. The dozer people usually have a lot of armor and are just like super tanky, so I think I should switch back to the cannons.
Arena Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program, number 8, rank B, final evaluation.
Got one of those crazy chain hand weapons.
Milktooth. Call sign, Honest Brute.
I like his emblem a lot, though.
Main system, activating combat mode.
Alright, so let's not get caught in his hand. Flamethrower, huh? First I've seen that. Flamethrower was weird.
Target destroyed. This concludes B rank evaluation. Well done.
Flamethrower was a weird weapon to work around.
Incoming comms.
Congratulations. surpassed rank B. It is a great honor to witness your evolution as a mercenary.
Thanks.
All Might exists for all mercenaries.
Alright, so nothing new, unfortunately. We're still in Chapter 3. So we have Eliminate Honest Brute, which we just did. Eliminate Honest Brute, a dozer hiding out in Grid 12. Extra rewards based on number of enemies destroyed. Let's just go ahead and do it again.
I'll cut to the chase. This is about the Ice Worm, that Institute relic you had a run-in with. Corpse might stand a chance if it were just the PCA they were teaming up against. But that monster is a whole other story. You can't just throw bodies at it. The thing that makes it such a pain in the ass is its perpetual reactive shield. Coral Tech. Takes advantage of the coral's directivity. Ordinary weapons can't touch it. So let's get extraordinary. I can make you something that'll punch a hole in that shield. But I'll need your help. You'll be heading to Grid 012. One of the first sectors they built. And it's barely holding up. That's where a little rat who betrayed R.A.D. is hiding out. Goes by the name of Honest Brute. His AC, Milktooth, was built by us. So its only flaw is that it's piloted by him. When he ran from R.A.D., he didn't just take credits in tech. He also took a secret project of mine. And that secret project is what we'll need to bust open the Ice Worm's shield.
Alright, Honest Brute. Time to go down for a second time.
You ready for this, tourist? No one's gonna miss Brute. And we all stand to gain.
Okay.
Repair kits remaining.
That damn freak's using my toys like they were his.
Make sure you keep clear of the laser sensors. They're set to activate the enemy machines.
A new friend from afar, just for me. What joy. Be still my beating heart.
God, this is annoying. Can't lock onto these things. They still count as MTs, though. Probably ain't gonna reach him. Figured as much. Hello. Some more over there. I think those are the last ones. Ooh, that was close. Okay, just him. Was I not inside of it? That was upsetting.
There's your way in. Brute can't be far.
Aw, son of a gun.
Keep an eye out for traps. They'll be much more dangerous in tight quarters.
not a weapon? Even more. No resupply?
Is this place some kind of hangar? The target AC must be nearby.
Ah, my new friend. You're here at last.
Alright, I'm gonna have to use left side for a little bit because I didn't use them evenly. Shoulders down on right. Oh no, I have last two, okay. Oh shit. Flamethrower in my face. That's the last repair kit. Oh, he has repairs. Man, he's quick for being so big. Yeah, that's it. I haven't hit him in a long time.
Slow, slow. Seems that was your last dance, friend. I'd offer flowers if I could find them.
He healed several times. I wonder if it's a time-based thing, like you have to do enough damage in a certain amount of time. The other mission leaned to us being able to trap him in a corner and focus our missiles on him there. That's what made him a lot easier.
Don't forget, the guy's a rat. This won't be smooth sailing. Is this place some kind of hangar? The target AC must be nearby.
Ah, my new friend. You're here at last. Brute! Ah, Carla, you've introduced me to such wonderful people. Wonderful things. The sweet melody of the generator. How Milktooth's heart sings.
Build that ACMRT twist. Don't underestimate it.
Okay, he yet again healed. Yeah, scaled again. How'd I miss my last rocket? Okay, so you just added multiple repairs, that's it. Mind alpha legs.
One new message.
This is Chatty Stick, RAD. Thanks for putting down Brute. The Chief's already in the workshop tweaking the rail cannon. And I've never seen her happier to be at work. That is all. Later, tourist.
That is all. Okay. What we get is a parts. No new weapon. Oh, and yeah, there was a weapon. Bad cook. Okay, so that's the flamethrower that we unlocked. Okay. Nothing else. I want to buy things. We've got tons of money over there. Haven't even, like, farmed money yet. Alright, so we got all the boosters, FCS, generators. And grab the minigun. The other minigun. Now we're pretty broke. Okay. Next mission. Defend the old spaceport. Defend the old spaceport and prevent its recapture by Planetary Closure Administration.
PCA are going to be fighting to win.
battle's over already.
Find out what's going on.
That's lovely how whenever you literally land and they're like, wait, something's not right. Pile driver.
Let's see how far they can fly. On borrowed wings.
Did that AC do all this?
They did a human C-461. We're not here to take back the Raven name. However,
sweet Jesus. That pile driver. Bit of an issue is the fact that they're every time that I stun them so far, they've just immediately gotten out of it, and I haven't been able to hit them with anything. That sucks.
One cannot fly on borrowed wings. It seems our gig isn't over yet, Raven.
I don't know how many more repair kits she had, but I think it was pretty close.
Rented human C-461.
Yeah. A little quick. I think we're gonna have to swap to something a little quicker also. I don't know if I want to go submachine guns or assault rifles. Do I have enough of a loadout to hold the two machine guns? Do. Let's try this. I feel like the machine guns, I get her stagger like super high pretty quick, and then for some reason it takes forever to get that last little bit. We got it this time. Just hadn't used those before, so needed to get used to them. I allowed myself to get overheated that first time, which was real bad. Took forever for them to cool down. Oh man, that was rough. Over already. Find out what's going on. Man, my forward thrust is not as good as I would think it would be. She's down to one, I think. Maybe two.
Just focus on the fight, 621.
AP at 30%.
That pilot just wiped out a PCA squad. Stay sharp, 621.
Now she's down to none.
Yes, Raven, I feel it too. This message has potential.
AP had 50%.
They overheated. Not good.
AP at 30%.
Let's get
ammunition at 50%.
Ah.
If we'd have gotten that last... that last stagger. It feels like... man, I don't know. I guess I just need to stop complaining. Get good.
Main system activating combat mode.
Commence mission. Wait, something's not right, 621.
The battle's over already.
Find out what's going on.
Okay, so it's pushing the button again once you activate boost is what caused you to do the kick. That hurt. Wow.
That pilot just wiped out a PCA squad. Stay sharp, 621.
The Raven is a simple resolve. To choose what one fights for.
Just focus on the fight, 621.
Hey. Don't you do it. Got her. What is that? Detonating missile launcher.
No new messages.
I've looked into the other Raven, the independent mercenary who attacked you. It turns out that Raven isn't an individual call sign. It's a title, passed down generations of mercenaries who champion the free will Raven stands for. They choose what to fight for, and take to the skies in flight. If that's what being a Raven means, then that's the name I want to keep calling you. Raven.
I mean, it's better than 621. Yeah. A decal. Raven's much better. Okay, so that missile launcher is a shoulder weapon, it looks like. Yep. Jesus. That's so weird. Historic data recovery. Salvage historical data scattered throughout the subterranean tunnel. No base pay. Compensation derived from sellable data recovered from PCA wrecks. I'm gonna go back in with the chain guns. I mean the machine guns.
Raven, I have a personal request to ask you. It's about the Angerbret tunnel, which is to be shut down after it was hit by a coral surge. I want to go there and survey the area. Even before the coral surge, that place had been all but abandoned. It's an old structure, dating far back into the colonization of Rubicon. There must be items of interest from throughout the planet's history there. As I'm sure you're aware, I have no resources with which to pay you. But I can propose an alternative. If you find any wrecks left by the PCA, you should try accessing them. Both the corporations and the Rubiconians are gathering data on PCA technology. Whatever you collect, I can exchange for credits and transfer the funds to you. I've taken a few liberties. Walter thinks you've gone on a geological survey. Thank you for doing this for me, Raven.
Main system activating combat mode.
Let's get started, Raven. I've already located several wrecks that we should be able to recover data from. I'll send the marker data. Is able to conduct data and can influence digital equipment. The effects of the coral surge must have brought some of the wrecks back online. Let's see what we can find. Data seems valuable too. I'm so glad this is turning into a profit. An older generation of AC. According to the timestamp, this was recorded 2 days before the fires of Ibis. This seems to be about the warning signs of the calamity, right before it struck. used to pilot these. This seems to be a recording of Domain, the Liberation Front's ideological leader. But this appears to be something exceptionally personal.
The hell is this? Electric discharge. Fixer robots didn't like me, I guess. Are you not one of them? I can destroy you either way. Am I worried about there being another coral explosion in here?
Inspecting data. It's a schematic for an SG craft.
I don't know that my mobility is as good as the previous one when I first did this mission. Drones down there. Took some finagling.
This data shed some light on the composition of the enforcement squads. Another old research institute, I see.
How did a freaking battleship get down here?
Humans. The same coral technology that created you. But without it, we never would have made contact. I'm not picking up any more data stores. If this outing has made you think about Rubicon's past or the nature of coral, then it was all worth it.
Archibus.
A heavy warship fleet.
In exchange, Balaam's in charge of putting down the beast. They also offered some top Vespers. Guess they don't trust us.
Better than nothing. I'll provide what support I can too.
Yeah, your mad scientists, R.E.D. or whatever, and that hound of yours.
Michigan. Don't underestimate 621. That hound always delivers.
Again, can you call me by something other than 621 or hound? Like, I've got other names.
One new message.
What kept you, 621? You're a famous mercenary now. Time to act like one. This next mission's all or nothing. Make sure you attend the briefing.
Woo! Shoulder weapon, stun needle launcher. That's different. Okay. We're at our hour mark, though. This will conclude our chapter into our chapter 3 mission. So, I hope everyone's enjoying the playthrough of Armored Core 6. If you are, please make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. And I will catch you on the next one.